Hi, I'm Amy Jones Timoney from the University of Kentucky, and today we are joined by Dean Dr. Robert DiPaola from the College of Medicine. Thank you so much for showing us around today.
Absolutely. No, happy to do that.
So we're in the Simulation Center here over in Chandler, and as we kind of walk through, if you can just start us off by talking a little bit about why you personally are so passionate about medicine.
Well, I think, you know, it's incredible. And as you know, the University of Kentucky College of Medicine and UK Healthcare has really grown over actually quite a few years in terms of numbers of students that we train, a number of residents and fellows that we train, numbers of researchers and educators that we train, as well as what we do in terms of key missions, in terms of clinical care, especially for Kentucky, key missions in terms of education and research as well. The wonderful thing about it as an academic medical center is it's all integrated. Everything from, you know, the basic sciences that are at the laboratory and discoveries and bringing that into the clinic. And our students have an opportunity to witness all of that. And this is an incredible facility where our students, residents, fellows, and other healthcare workforce have an opportunity to practice their skills in many of the interventions that we need to properly take care of patients. And you can see here by you know, some of the rooms that these are set up like a room that would be in the hospital or in an operating room or in an emergency room setting, so that our students have an opportunity to really practice and learn when they're here in their training. Simulation has become a big part of medical education throughout the country.
What does it take to be a medical student at the University of Kentucky?
We look for students that have a number of different characteristics. Obviously, grades are important in terms of our admissions process. There's a national exam, the MCAT exam. We have what we call core competencies, and it includes professionalism. It includes the ability to communicate well with patients, with coworkers. We look at the ability of students to work in teams, to understand how to, you know, connect with, you know, various disciplines and bring that together for the best care of a particular patient. So it's not only the academic skills, but it's also the communication skills, the social skills, the professionalism skills that are required for, our very best future of medicine physicians. Amongst the core competencies, it includes a lifelong learning approach and critical thinking. I mean, if you actually ask the question of, gee, when new evidence comes up, how often do we have new things that a physician out in practice needs to pay attention to? And right now, if you were to ask that question, there's almost a doubling of the evidence, the published evidence, every about 4 years or so. So physicians out there in practice or in an academic environment or in a university environment or hospital environment are really needing to understand how to have lifelong learning, to take those evidences that come up and figure out how to use them to the best benefit of their patients and keep up with that on a regular basis. We spend a lot of time in terms of training our students to be lifelong learners, and it's going to be a critical piece going forward.
And you have learners beyond medical students, correct?
We train scientists here. We train instructors here that'll go on in careers to either teach or do research. We train residents and fellows, so that's where beyond medical school, they learn their particular specialty of choice. We have programs here with over 800 residents and fellows. We had an increase in our medical school class recently with two new campus expansions, one in Bowling Green and one now in Northern Kentucky, which will increase our class size within the next 4 years or so. So we really look forward to, you know, training our future physicians to help us here in Kentucky.
Well, it's definitely cool to see some of the spaces where that training is taking place, but now we're going to head across campus so that we can talk a little bit more about research and some broader goals of the College of Medicine.
Absolutely. Be happy to show you.
Thank you. We've made our way over to Research Building 2. Tell me about why this space is so important to the College of Medicine.
This has been incredible to the growth of research to really all the colleges throughout the campus, and especially the College of Medicine as well. And as you can see, many of the areas here in these open areas foster collaboration. It allows us to recruit the very best and, you know, for some of our very best, opportunities to grow their research with more space. So the facility has been, you know, and had already a tremendous impact. We were able to recruit our new chair of toxicology cancer biology here. He was one of the first occupants. In a little while, you know, see his laboratory as well. And I don't think that we would have been in a position to attract some of these absolute superstars. In fact, he's a faculty member who came over from Purdue with four R01s, which are each in and of themselves very competitive grants in the area of prostate cancer biology, which is allows us to grow a whole new area that can then feed into what we do in terms of the clinical end from these discoveries to impact patients in need in Kentucky.
Well, let's head upstairs and talk a little bit more about that connection between research and clinical care. So we've made our way to the lab space here in RB2. Tell me a little bit about how important it is that the research that you're doing is actually translating into the kind of care that you have in your clinical programs.
Well, as you know, it is incredibly important that that we continue to have new discoveries. We have many patients in need, many areas, at least on the medical front, that still need new therapies and new options. And it's really through new discovery here at the bench where we're able to, come up with new areas where we have new targets and new therapies. In multiple different areas, in terms of cardiovascular research, in terms of cancer, in terms of neuroscience research, in terms of addiction research, in terms of diabetes and obesity, just as a few examples of some of our signature areas. Some of the programs that we've launched are trying to bring people together in larger teams. Mentioned this multidisciplinary value program, or MVP. That brought together teams of more basic scientists with clinical researchers to take some of the discoveries that are in the laboratory and get them into the clinic. I mean, examples include areas related to, cardiovascular and neuroscience and cancer. We also have another area that we're focusing on, and that's what we call implementation science. So for the discoveries that have occurred and evidence that we've proven, getting that actually out into the community is a goal that we have in terms of greater impact for those patients in need throughout the state of Kentucky and beyond.
It's clear that through education, through clinical care, through research, the College of Medicine is really having an impact on the state and around the country and the globe. Is there anything else that you would like the rest of campus to know about your college?
I think that our college is incredibly collaborative. We have very strong researchers, strong leaders in areas of research in all the key areas. I think that, one of our strengths is this, this passion that we see many of our faculty have and our staff have to actually do their very best to actually have impact with the research that they do toward, healthcare and towards patient care. And being all in one system as an academic medical center allows us to take it right from discovery to, to have impact. But I think the collaborative nature of our researchers and the strength of our researchers is just absolutely amazing here at the University of Kentucky.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to show us around these wonderful new spaces today. We really appreciate it.
Absolutely. Happy to do that.
And if you would like more information on the College of Medicine, just visit the website on the screen.